Back in the 60s, I began studying the chemical composition of natural baits. My goal was to identify chemicals that stimulate feeding in marine animals. These chemicals are known as feeding stimulants. I first began working with snails to see if I could induce feeding behaviors without the presence of any actual food source. I then moved up to shrimp. My goal was to see if I could get shrimp to attack a non-food item as if it were food. The delivery device is getting a lot of attention because our feeding stimulants are being released from it. Then I moved up the food chain to perform the same experiment on pinfish. Using synthetic feeding stimulants present in shrimp, we were able to trick these pinfish into thinking a rubber bulb is a piece of shrimp. We were definitely onto something. My next goal was to see if I could put these stimulants in a water-soluble gel.
And so as a spin-off from that, there was an effort made to ask the question, well, what sort of material could we incorporate these substances in so that we could create or construct a bait?
And from here, Fishbites was born.
Fishbait. It suggests wriggling worms or pieces of fish that soon start smelling fishy. But scientists in Florida are proving that doesn't have to be the way.
At the University of Florida's Whitney Marine Laboratory, scientists are learning more about how marine animals perceive what's going on in their underwater environment. The project has produced important scientific data, and there's also been a practical spin-off, artificial fish bait.
I'm gonna show you guys a little trick. Just fish bite with a jig. It's on a Carolina rig, but it doesn't matter. You can throw this on, you can do it on, same thing on a Pompano rig. But it's more fun on this. Oh, there it is. Fish numero uno coming in on the fish bites.